kind of help give Braden that nickname, Braden Miracle Whip. And Miracle Whip getting set to take on Rosa Rosso. This should be one of the more entertaining fights of the night. Lowry working with low kicks here early.
Lowry looks good and poised. Rosa Rosso coming on with some, you know, thick kicks already.
Well, and you're right. Being 17 years of age, you don't expect a guy to be very poised. But this young man has a lot of fights under his belt.
Yes, he does. And he's staying right in there, too. He's definitely got to be careful, you know, against the southpaw, walking right into that left hand.
Obviously, we haven't had a chance to see Rosa Rosso before, but everything that I've heard is this man is just absolutely game, and this really should be one of the better fights of the night. Nice.
Yeah, so you see that right there, that power left. You know, something you got to be careful with the Orthodox fighters walking right into it. You're walking into that power left at all times.
Some big shots. Lowry dropped here by Rosa Rosso. Now Rosa Rosso looking for the finish potentially.
This is where Rosa Rosso doesn't want to be with Lowry, though, because Lowry's amazing off his back. That's something that, you know, speaks volume about, you know, these amateurs, even though they are amateurs, they're very experienced, both of them.
Well, and you can just see the power that Rosa Rosso has. I mean, he is well built, and that's something that Braden, at just 17 years of age, has yet to grow into all of that power.
Yeah. Braden is extremely dangerous here off his back, and if he can sweep in here, you know, get those legs up high enough, he can definitely set up a triangle or, you know, multiple other things.
Well, I actually talked to him prior to the fight, and he said, I am super comfortable right here, and I feel like I can get a finish if it goes to the ground. So even though he's on his back right here, he is not in a position that he is scared of whatsoever. And he may be more comfortable here than he is standing on the feet.
Oh, of course. Trying to set up a triangle right here. He can just pull his head down and get that leg under that knee, and that ankle under that knee. Also there, he can still look back to
him. Rosa Rosa showing off some of that strength.
He's going to stand up.
Inside 1 minute to go here in round number one. Let's see, maybe a small cut.
Call for a takedown. They know that, you know, your opponent does have a lot of power. Rosa does definitely have a lot of power in his hands.
Rosa Rosa is just built, man.
Stacked.
For 135 pounds, he looks incredibly good.
It's like a 170.
Oh, those are some big shots.
Now here again, like, Braden's still in here, you know. Good job by the ref of not, you know, stopping that early.
See Lowry almost inviting him to the ground. Here it is.
I mean, he just kind of swooped into that. Right here, right here. Only has 10 seconds, not really enough time to do much.
Well, it shows you one thing. Lowry is very much aware of this power of Rosa Rosa, and he wants to stay away from it as much as possible.
Another thing, too, he's never probably felt this type of power, you know.
Well, an incredible first round there for Rosa Rosso, showing off that power, knocked Lowry down twice in that round. Now, Braden able to survive. He did show a bit off his back, but right now you're going to have to weather the storm that is the left hand of Rosa Rosso.
Yes, he's got to be careful for walking in. He's, you know, as an Orthodox fighter, like I said, and unexperienced, you know, he definitely has a great ground game, but, you know, his stand-up-wise, he's got to circle away from that power hand, and it is really hard as a right-handed fighter to do that if you haven't faced a lot of, you know, southpaw opponents.
And I just don't think he's ever seen someone with power like this.
Exactly. You have power, you have another unorthodox stance. It's a lot to walk into.
You can tell that shot that hit him early on stunned him, and it's the first time we've seen Lowry catch a shot like that by any means. And Rosa Rosso over there in the corner looking very confident. He was up off the stool quickly. I don't even know if he ever went to the stool. I never even saw him sit down.
I didn't see a stool on his side.
I think he was just flat out ready to go. But as you mentioned, if Braden can get this down to the ground, it's a place he's incredibly comfortable.
He can level the field there at this point.
Round two underway. Certainly round one had to belong to Rosa Rosso.
Calling for a level change already. Oh man, that was a hard left.
Lowry down once again. Rosa Rosso wants it back.
Lowry's hurt here. He's got to be careful trying to stand up. You know, he was slightly rocked there and trying to stand up. Almost caught another one. But hey, he's pulling right back in where he wants to go. Lowry's comfortable here. He can sit here all day long and play with him.
Look at this. Well, you saw Rosa Rosso wanted him to get back to his feet. He does not want to be down here. He understands that he's got such a huge advantage on the feet that he could lose this fight with Lowry bringing it to the ground.
Yeah, and Lowry's probably recovering a little bit right now, too.
set up an armbar there. He lost it. He's got to be careful right here.
Lowry bleeding a bit here. His Rosa landed a big left to drop him a moment ago.
He's digging. You know, Lowry's going to dig for that takedown, and he's making Rosa defend it, but he's falling right into Lowry's guards, I think, is what the plan is anyway, right?
I'll tell you what, Rosa, he showed pretty well so far, though, on the ground as well.
Yeah, he's doing a great job of, you know, keeping top control. Lowry hasn't really been able to set anything up.
Well, that's what we heard about Denzel Rosa. He's very complete, doesn't have a lot of weakness in his game, and is full of power. He has showcased that so far halfway through this fight.
Definitely wants him to set up a triangle and walk into the motions here. But Rosa is such a wide guy, too. It's good and it's bad. It's hard to get around him. And once you do, it's a little bit easier to submit someone whose neck's closer to the shoulder. But he's so wide and so big.
Inside 1 minute to go here in round number two. So far dominated by Denzel Rosa in that big left hand.
Yeah.
But it's never over at any point with the submission skills that Lowry possesses.
I think Miracle Whip has had time to recover here, which may be good for him too, you know. Took that hard shot early on, you know, split him up. I don't really agree with that, but on amateur level, you never know, you know what I mean?
Corner calling for him to change
level. Pull him right back in the guard.
And you can tell that just has to be the game plan at this point.
Yeah, I mean, it's got to be because he's not even pushing through for a takedown. He's kind of just, you know, lackadaisically going forward and pulling in his guard.
Well, we wanted to see how Braden Lowry would stack up against some of the big boys, if you will, of the 135-pound division. And Rosa is absolutely
Yes, sir.
He has been starching some people as of late, and he showed Lowry that power through two rounds. He's got, I think, four different knockdowns to this point. And it's really been an impressive showing so far from Denzel Rosa. And even on the ground, he's been very game.
Yeah, I mean, he's definitely, you know, held top control. And he's not. We haven't seen him transition for any submissions or anything like that. But he's winning.
Yeah.
You know, he's scoring points.
He's well out ahead here. No way that he loses this fight unless he were to be submitted, you would think.
Right.
Lowry is going to absolutely need to look for that submission here in round three. And he's capable of doing it. But right now, this fight has been dominated by Denzel Rosa, representing 4 Ounce Fight Club out of Houston, Texas. Here we go, set for round number three. It's a bad spot there.
Yeah, he's trying to pull him down, and that's all he can do at this point. I mean, here again, they're calling for moving hips so he can set up an armbar in a triangle.
Well, Dynamite.
So how about it, guys? As my friend Steven Tyler from Aerosmith would say, I'm back in the saddle again. So the bantamweights have dominated the card tonight. And, guys, I've got to comment. How huge is Denzel Rosa for
fella.
A bantamweight?
A big fella.
We were talking about that. So much power in that left hand. And we understand how great Braden Lowry is. He's only 17 years old. He never felt power like that. And Rosa has come out and showed off that power in the left hand through the first two rounds.
I mean, Denzel is a physical specimen out there, but just such a huge guy.
I have no idea. I want his diet.
And I mean, 135.4, the dude is lean, mean, ripped, and rocking out there.
So Braden's going to continue to try to set up a triangle right here. I mean, at this point, I think, you know, the way it's going to be scored and, you know, constantly be knocked down and not being able to do it on his feet, I think this is going to be what he needs to go to. It's not a bad call.
But it's such a great experience for him, guys. You know, he came out as somewhat of a phenom, such a young man, caught this sport so fast, saw a lot of success. He really needed to get in there with a monster really get to know what it's like to be thrown around, pushed around. This is just going to help him in the long run, win or lose this fight here.
You're absolutely correct. And he just hasn't grown into his power yet. He's just 17 years of age. One day he's going to have that power as well. And I'd be very scared if I was the 135-pound division.
I mean, one day he's going to have that power, a hair on his chest. All things are going to happen for him here real soon.
Well, the great thing about it, too, is, you know, these amateur fights are a way to build your resume. But, hey, when you turn pro, it's all kind of wiped clean, you know.
Yeah, it really gets more dangerous when you step into the pro, the shark tank, as they call it, because now, you know, that record counts. It affects not only your draw ability, but it affects your profitability as well.
Yes.
You know how much money you're going to make per fight, but again, this is just a great test here for Braden Lowry. And look, he has held his own, done very well, and we've seen him progress. He's not so much offensively on his back, but he has learned how to be very defensive and protect himself on his back. So again, you're seeing that progression of the young man getting better as a fighter. And I love our referee, Bam Bam, Basil Maju, been there. Hey, bringing the action up, giving the fans what they want to see, and giving the fighters an opportunity as well.
And that's, you know, that even that jab's dangerous. You know, he's throwing out a hook there, followed with a jab. And Braden's got to be careful walking in a straight left.
Rosa was just so crisp with all of his striking.
Braden pulling down again into his guard.
So just about to round things out here in fight number three. Guys, I think we're going to go to the judges' scorecard. I'm going to find out who our winner is going to be and let you know inside the cage.
Well, I think we know who our winner is going to be here. Rosa Rosso has been dominating this fight, probably the most dominant performance we've seen so far here tonight in our fifth fight of the night. And again, that's not to take anything away from Braden Lowry. We understand that Braden Lowry is going to be an absolutely sensational fighter. It's just he ran into one of the biggest, baddest dudes around the area right now. And there's a chance Denzel Rosaroso won't be an amateur for 2 months longer.
No, sir.
Because this young man can flat out get it.
A great guy. You know, and even saying, I mean, amazing power, good wrestling, good grappling standpoints. And to be able to stay in there and, you know, grapple with Braden, say something too for Rosa Rosa, you know.
Well, he is very complete as a fighter. His shoulders are so wide, man. It's absolutely crazy how wide this young man is. He is just, he's built, and he is really looking like a menace right now for the 135-pound division. Having a bit of fun there, I guess, in the cage at the end. Dynamite, ready with your results.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of Fast and Furious Mixed Martial Arts Section, we are going to the judges' scorecard. All three judges have seen and scored this fight the same way. Therefore, declaring your winner by unanimous decision, fighting in the blue corner, Denzel
Denzel Rosaroso flexing on him, and he flexed on everybody in the building here tonight. I'm telling you, man, he has put together the best performance of the night so far, completely dominating our fifth fight of the night, and he now improves to 4-0 as an amateur. Braden picks up his first loss. We've got a lot more to see from Braden. This is only going to make him better as a fighter. We understand what kind of young man he is out of Shreveport, Louisiana. He's only going to continue to grow and get better, and he'll use this as fuel to the fire.
Yeah, this is definitely a good, I mean, you know, it's not a bad loss for Braden. The experience is great. The feeling, the power.
Keep your head up, Austin.